Here's another thing that I wanted to ask you about, and you kind of touched on this a while ago. Atom was very explicit in his statement this morning that he didn't want to pursue libel charges against the two. And you kind of touched on this in the beginning of our conversation when you said that was one of the concerns that he really raised from the very beginning. Why was that important to Atom?
That's important because libel law is used, weaponized against journalists. And he obviously doesn't want to be a situation where he uses the same law that is used against journalists, against those who perpetrate these really terrible actions with him. But let's be sure too that he qualified that with the phrase "for now," because we also told him that you cannot rule it out completely if the libel is really so vile that it's so dangerous that we have to take action also using the libel. So but as a general rule, libel is not, now we were also asked this morning in the press conference about whether or not this kind of action, remember this is civil action or for damages, mm-hmm. A reasonable amount of $2 million, not too big, not too small. This is not about money for Atom, this is about accountability. So $2 million is just okay. It costs a little bit of hardship, but not too much on those who will pay that if a judge rules in our favor. Hmm. But the very important part of what Atom said this morning also was that can this kind of case be weaponized against journalists, activists? No, because I'm telling you, Carmina, it took us months to research this, to prepare this, to get it in the right shape. And they're not going to do that. They're very careless about, about red tagging. They don't know who they're red tagging. They're not going to spend a lot of time. This is pro bono, of course. We're doing this because we're truth advocates in the movement against disinformation. And when Atom was asking this question of accountability, we immediately told him we're willing to take on this case pro bono for you.
Which brings us to my final question. Attorney Lavinia, you speak about accountability, but the bigger issue here, or is the bigger issue here, having that big Democratic space to be critical when there's a need to be critical, to having that space to have a dissenting opinion, or again, having that democratic space for enough critical thinking to happen. Is that the bigger picture here?
Yes. In fact, my lead convener of the Movement Against Disinformation, Attorney Rico Domingo, stressed that in his own remarks this morning in the press conference. He was saying that that's, in fact, is the bigger picture, that if you allow this red tagging to continue, it stops discussion, right?
Yes, Attorney Lavinia, go ahead.
If a journalist, you say that to the journalist that
Dean Tony. Okay, I think we just lost Dean. Dean, are you still there?
Shake him and make him the inventor. Sorry, I'm here. Manu, you don't hear me?
Yeah, just your final thoughts on, you were saying, please continue about your thoughts on democratic space, and that's the bigger picture here, and having that room for critical thinking to happen, and for being, having that space to have dissent. Go ahead.
Yes, that was the point of my colleague, Attorney Rico Domingo, the co-convener of the Movement Against Disinformation, this morning. Like, if Atom or any journalist like you ask questions, now you don't even have to criticize, you ask questions. Mm-hmm. And then you said, no, why are you asking that, you're a communist? Then you'll be intimidated to stop asking questions, right? For me, a climate justice advocate, if I criticize the government for its wrong energy policy or, its reclamation decisions, and then I'm told, stop that, you're a communist, that stops discussion on a very important issue for the country and for the world. So that's what we don't want. Special human rights, of course, is one of those things. We have to be able to assert human rights. There's two kids missing in Bataan, you know, that's been reported missing. We should be able to raise those questions and episode. Don't raise those questions because you're going to be a communist, charged as a communist if you do that.
Right.
That's all.
We're going to have to leave it at that. Attorney Tony Lavinia there, lead counsel for journalist Atom Aralio, joining us this noon. Really appreciate it, Dean Tony. Take care. Keep safe.
Thank you. See you again, Carmina.
See you.
Bye.
Take care.